Hello everybody, I am Sayoni and I'll help you learn and understand science. And so today our chapter is nutrition in plants. Okay, so in this chapter we will cover some of the topics that are modes of nutrition in plant. What nutrition is, we'll see later in this chapter, followed by photosynthesis, what type of food are made by plants, okay, and some heterotrophic nutrition and its type. All these topics will be covered in this chapter. Before we start this chapter, just stay indoors, okay? Don't go outside and start playing, because it will be safer for you and your family to be inside. And so utilize the time that you have in studying and playing also, but stay indoors, okay? So let's start. Before understanding nutrition, we must know what nutrients are, okay? All of you must have heard your mother saying, have your milk, have your milk. Milk is a complete food. It will give you protein. You'll grow faster, okay? Milk mein calcium hai. So all these components which comprise the food basically are called nutrients. These nutrients are very essential for our body, okay? We have to consume it from outside so that we can do our daily work properly, and to do that work we obviously need energy, okay? So energy we get from carbohydrates and fats. You have learned all this in your previous classes. And vitamins help us to stay healthy. Fruits give us vitamins and these protect us from various diseases. And minerals are also very essential for our body. Okay, these are called nutrients. What nutrients do is they help us build our bodies. It is not only applicable for plants, but it is also necessary for animals. Okay, so nutrients help us to build our bodies, to grow. Okay, just imagine, were you born with the same size as you are now today? No, na? You have grown. Every child grows, okay? For growing, we always need nutrients, okay? To repair damaged parts, if you ever cut your finger or get hurt, okay? Obviously, your body heals it. For that healing part also, we need different types of nutrients, okay? And most importantly, nutrients give us energy to carry out, okay? That's why we are advised to have a balanced diet which contains all the nutrients in a definite proportion. Okay, now since we are now familiar with the term nutrient, now we move on to nutrition. Okay, you never confuse yourself with nutrients and nutrition. Okay, nutrients are components of food, while nutrition is a mode or way. एक तरीका है ये, ठीक है? Way of taking food by an organism and its utilization by the body. Okay? You eat food and your body utilizes those nutrients that you have obtained from the food is called basically nutrition. Okay? Nutrition is of two types. First is autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. First, we'll learn about autotrophic nutrition and then we will move on to heterotrophic nutrition. Here's the flowchart that will help you memorize and understand the variety of nutrients that we have. Okay, nutrition is basically the way we take food and utilize it. Nutrition is of two kinds, autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. And heterotrophic nutrition can be further divided into four parts. So there are four types of heterotrophic nutrition. First is parasitic mode of nutrition, saprophytic mode of nutrition, insectivorous mode of nutrition, and symbiotic mode of nutrition. All of these we will learn later in this chapter. Okay, so let's move on with autotrophic nutrition. First, let's understand what the term tells us. Autotrophic. Auto means self. Okay? That means khud se. ठीक है? बाहर से किसी की help नहीं लेनी. Then trophic. Trophic means nutrition. Auto means self and trophic means Nutrition. The nutrition is the term that you are familiar with. You have studied right now what nutrition is. Auto means self, okay? Khud se. So combining both these terms, autotrophic nutrition is basically process of making its own food, okay? When an organism makes its own food or is able to make its own food is called autotrophic nutrition. Okay, now you have already learned about photosynthesis and all, you know the basics of the photosynthesis, and we always say plants make their own food. Okay, all that organisms, those who make their own food, are called autotrophs. Okay, the mode of nutrition of autotrophs is autotrophic nutrition. Okay, if someone asks you what is the mode of nutrition of autotrophs, then mode of nutrition for autotrophs will be autotrophic nutrition. Okay, this is the simplest way we can understand the autotrophic nutrition. Okay, so since ab hum bade ho gaye hain, now we have to give our answers in more scientific way. Okay, so autotrophic nutrition is a nutritional system whereby means by which complex molecules like carbohydrates, fats and proteins that are essential for life. You cannot live without all of these nutrients. Okay, essential for life emerge through photosynthesis. Okay, when plants do photosynthesis, what they make? Carbohydrates, fats and proteins. Okay, so autotrophic nutrition is basically a nutritional system, okay, which makes complex molecules like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, which are very essential for our life. Some of the examples of the organisms that use autotrophic nutrition to feed themselves and grow are certain types of microscopic bacteria, okay, algae and majority of green plants. All of these depend on autotrophic nutrition for their lives. Okay, now autotrophic nutrition is carried on with the help of photosynthesis. Okay, if you don't make food, you can't eat. Am I clear? Similarly, if plants don't make food, they won't be able to utilize it for their energy. Okay, plants are also doing various kind of activities like you are doing, so they also need energy. So for that energy, plants need food, and from where they will get those food? They will get the food from photosynthesis. They will make it by their own. So for autotrophic nutrition, photosynthesis is very necessary. Photosynthesis is the process by which plants make their own food. Okay, that we know. But plants can't there make food if they don't have any material. What are those material? What are the things that plants need to make their own food? Okay, I hope you have food. Okay, I hope you are getting the answer. Yes, the things are carbon dioxide, water and sunlight. These are the things that plants need to photosynthesis. So let's understand the process of photosynthesis. As we did with autotrophic nutrition, we'll do the same thing with photosynthesis. Sometimes you need to understand what the word means, and rest of its meaning will come to you on its own. Okay? So photosynthesis, it is a word formed with two words. Okay? Photo means light, and synthesis means to make or to prepare. So when we make food with the help of light, that is sunlight, we call it photosynthesis. Okay, it is a process in which green plants, it is very necessary to mention green plants, because the green pigment which is in the plant is called chlorophyll. It is very necessary for photosynthesis to occur. Prepare their food in the presence of air, which is from air what they take. They take carbon dioxide. The leaves of the plants absorb carbon dioxide, water and sunlight. in the presence of sunlight, the photosynthesis occurs. They don't absorb the water from leaves, okay? They absorb water from the roots. The leaves are responsible for the absorption or exchange of gases, okay? So CO2 is the gas that is present in our atmosphere. So the leaves absorb this CO2 and they carry on with photosynthesis. So photosynthesis actually hota kya hai? We have now understood that photosynthesis is the process of making food. Okay, but actually what happens is that chlorophyll converts the solar energy into chemical energy to synthesize starch during the process of photosynthesis. Okay, am I clear? If you have any doubts, just refer to the books or read these slides. You will be very clear about the topic. Okay, so in photosynthesis actually what happens, conversion of solar energy into chemical energy to synthesize starch. Okay, sometimes you will notice that I have used the word glucose, or the books have used the word glucose, and sometimes they have used sugar, and sometimes they have used sugar, okay, and sometimes they have used starch. Okay, so glucose is the smallest unit and they can be used as synonyms. Okay, for your level you can use glucose or sugar or starch in the place of each other, but some glucose combine to form sugar and some sugars combine to form starch. Okay, starch is a very large molecule and glucose is the simplest food that plant makes. Okay, so moving on, since we have already understood what photosynthesis is, now some substances that are required for photosynthesis we need to understand. There are four things which are very necessary for photosynthesis. First is sunlight, which is the source of energy. Without sunlight there will be no energy and the plants will not be able to make their food. Okay, mama gas pe se cooker rakh deti aur khana apne aap ban nahi jata hai na, gas ko on karna padta hai na. She lights the gas and then it cooks. So what the stove is doing is it is providing the energy that is required to make food. Okay, similarly plants also need the energy, so that energy is provided from the sunlight. Okay, second thing is chlorophyll. Okay, the sunlight is the source of energy, but plants will not be able to use the sunlight unless and until they have chlorophyll. Okay, chlorophyll is the green pigment. The green color of the leaves is due to the presence of chlorophyll. Okay, chlorophyll is a green pigment. Keep this in mind, chlorophyll is a green pigment. Okay, what this pigment does is it absorbs the energy from the sunlight and converts the solar energy into chemical energy. So if a plant lacks chlorophyll, it will not be able to absorb the sunlight, and if it does not absorb the sunlight there will be no photosynthesis. Okay, so therefore chlorophyll is very necessary for photosynthesis to occur. Next we have carbon dioxide. You have heard of the nutrient carbohydrate. Okay, carbohydrate is basically made from carbon dioxide and water. Carbohydrate is composed of carbon dioxide and water. Since the name here, you can from here understand